Pipes and Cisterns, Part 3.
Hi, I am Daniel D'Souza and welcome to Aptitude Academy. This is Part 3 on the lecture on pipes and cisterns. Let's start with the problems.
Problem 1. An electric pump can fill a tank in 3 hours. Because of a leak in the tank, it took 3.5 hours to fill the tank. If the tank is full, how much time will the leak take to empty it?
Alright, now in your first problem, you have an electric pump as an inlet pipe, but you also have a leakage. Now, they said that if you only have an electric pump that fills a tank, it fills it in 3 hours. But if you have an electric pump and also a leakage, it fills it in 3.5 hours. Now, the way to proceed with this kind of problem is that you understand the statements. Now, here, only your electric pump is working. In your second statement, they've said that if your electric pump is working, the first one, and a leakage, then it takes 3.5 hours, that is an additional 30 minutes. Now, you know that 3.5 hours is 3, 2 is a 6, plus 1, 7 by 2. 7 by 2 hours, right? It's the same thing. I just simplified this fraction. Alright, now, if it fills in 3 hours, every hour does how much work? I'm just writing this here. 1 over 3, right? This one does how much work? If it fills it in 7 by 2 hours, every hour it does 2 by 7 of the total work. Correct? Now, see this, alright? Now you have electric pump. Now you know that the leakage is negative work, right? It removes water. So if you take electric pump minus of electric pump plus leakage, right? You will get it. Let's denote electric pump by E. It's just for your understanding. And electric pump plus leakage. So minus of E plus L, right? If you simplify it, it becomes E minus L. E and E cancels. So you're left with minus L. That is a leakage pipe, right? So now let's apply the same thing here. Now I've got 1 by 3. Just keep this inside. You've got 1 by 3, your electric pump, minus 2 by 7. That is your electric pump plus leakage. Now if you simplify this, your LCM will come out to be 7, 3s are 21. 7 minus 3s are 2 into 3 is 6. So this is 1 over 21. Every hour, 1 over 21 part is removed by the leakage. So in how much time will the leakage empty the tank? The inverse of it. So 21 hours. This is your final answer. Alright, let's move on to problem number 2.
Problem 2. Two pipes can fill a cistern in 14 hours and 16 hours respectively. The pipes are opened simultaneously and it is found that due to a leakage in the bottom, it took 32 minutes more to fill the cistern. When the cistern is full, in what time will the leak empty it?
Alright, now in your second problem, you have two inlet pipes. You have one that fills in 14 hours, one that fills in 16 hours. They said that it opens simultaneously. Alright, now both fill. Now, but they've also said that due to a leakage, it actually takes 32 minutes more to fill. Alright, now let's write down what we have. We've written about the two pipes. Now we know that when the work by two pipes is done, plus the leakage, okay, it would take additional 32 minutes. Alright, now, a simple way to approach these kind of problems is just forget about the leakage first. Just assume that you have two pipes. Alright, now let's start from there. You just have two pipes, one that fills in 14 hours and one that fills in 16 hours. How much time will it take? Now, every hour, 1 by 14 plus 1 by 16. Now, the LCM of 14 and 16 will be 112. Alright, 14, this will be 8 plus 16, 7. So, this is 15 upon 112. So every hour, this much of the tank gets filled. If only these two pipes are on. I'm not considering the leakage now. Alright, so this much. So every, so how much time will it take? It will be the inverse. 112 upon 15 hours. Right? Now, let's consider the leakage. Before that, let's simplify this. Now, what is 15 divided by, 112 divided by 15? It comes out to be 7.466 hours. Now, but you don't know what is 0.466, right? So to simplify it, you go on for this part. Come here. It will be 7 hours. Keep that at the side. And you don't know what is 0.466 hours. So multiply 0.466 into 60. You will get 28 minutes. Now we got 7 hours and 28 minutes. Now let's consider the leakage. Right. They've said that with the leakage, it takes an additional 32 minutes. Now just look at this for a while. What is 28 minutes plus 32 minutes? 60 minutes. 60 minutes is an hour. So 7 plus 1. So this comes out to be 8 hours. Right? Now, so we know that when it is just the pipes, every hour how much work is done? 15 over 112. And with the leakage, it is 1 by 8. Now, as I said in the previous example, take the work done by the positive pipes, that is the filling pipes, minus it from the work done by the filling pipes and the leakage together. So here you go, 15 by 112 minus 1 by 8. So if you take an LCM, it will be 112. This will be 15 minus 14. This gives you 1 over 112. This part is removed by the leakage every hour. So at the end, how much time will the leakage take? 112 hours. This is your final answer. All right, now let's move on to problem 3.
Problem 3. Two pipes A and B can fill a tank in 36 minutes and 45 minutes respectively. A waste pipe C can empty the tank in 30 minutes. First, A and B are opened. After 7 minutes, C is also opened. In how much time is the tank full?
Now, in the third problem, you know that pipe A and pipe B work for the first 7 minutes. Alright, let's forget about pipe C for now. Now, what is the part filled in the first 7 minutes? 7 into how much is filled every minute? Now, every minute, pipe A fills 1 over 36 and pipe B fills 1 over 45. If you take an LCM, it comes out to be 180. 36 5s are 180 and 45 4s are 180. So this is 7 into 9 over 180. Now 9 ones are 920s are, right? So 7 by 20. Now, after 7 minutes, due to the combined action of A and B, 7 over 20th part is filled. Now what is the remaining part? Now let's consider 1 to be a full tank, right? 20 upon 20 minus 7 over 20. What is this? 20, you take here, so it becomes 13 over 20. Now this is the part of the tank that is remaining to be filled after the 7 minutes. Now let's calculate how much time will it take if all three pipes are working. Now the remaining part is 13 over 20. Now let's see how to fill that. You've got A and B and C. C is active after the 7th minute. Now let's take the per minute equation. It comes out to be 1 over 36 plus 1 over 45, both are inlet pipes, minus 1 over 30. The C is an outlet pipe. Now let's take a LCM, comes out to be 180, 36 into 5 plus 45 into 4 minus 6. So this is 5 plus 4, 9, 9 minus 6 is 3. So this comes out to be 3 upon 180. 3 ones are, 360s are, so 1 over 60. Now look at this, 1 by 60 is filled every minute. So 13 by 20 fills in X minutes. Right? So if you cross multiply, you will get X is equal to, right, 13 over 20. Now this would be 60 would get multiplied here down. Right? You take it this side. So it is into 60. Alright? Now 20 ones are, 20 threes are. So this is 13 into 3, 39 minutes. Now, here is one place where everybody makes a mistake. 39 will be one of the options, but it is not the answer. You have to account for the first 7 minutes. So your actual answer will be 39 plus 7. That is 46 minutes. This is your final answer. Alright, so this was part 3 on pipes and cisterns, where we saw the basic concept of leakage and how to deal with its problems. Alright, if you found this video helpful, do leave me a comment and like my videos. Subscribe to my channel. Thank you.
Got a doubt? Leave me a comment and I'll get back to you as soon as possible.